I've been curating parts for this setup over countless years, and I finally think that I've got it in a really good spot. This video is going to cover my work from home productivity setup for the year of 2023. So we're starting the year off with an absolute bang. I'm gonna go over every part, and just as a disclaimer, everything that you are going to see in this video is going to be listed down in the description below, and they are affiliate links. They do support me as a creator. So keep that in mind. If you want to buy anything from the setup, they'll be down in the description. First things first is going to be the complete foundation of this setup, which is going to be the desk. I'm currently using the Autonomous.ai Smart Desk 2. I got this back in 2020, and it has been my full-time workhorse for this setup since then. It's a sit-stand desk with gray bottoms and a bamboo desktop that has lasted, like I said, from 2020. I haven't scratched it. It stayed in pristine condition and still works perfectly. I have been looking for a bit of a longer desktop that I am maybe thinking of going to Home Depot or Lowe's and getting like a kitchen top or a butcher top and just kind of treating it or untreating it and using that for the desktop instead. But so far, so good. I don't exactly remember the dimensions that this desktop is. I think it is 53 inches wide and then 31 inches long. It is somewhere around there. But again, like I said, I'm trying to look for a longer desktop, but this is what I'm working with right now. It's got a good range of heights that I can select from, as well as different presets. I can set 4 predetermined heights that I can just click of a button, have it go to that height, and I'm good to go. So if I want to go to a standing position or a sitting position, I can do it fairly easily. Next thing is going to be what I'm sitting on right now, which is going to be the chair. This is the All33 chair. This was featured on Shark Tank, and I kind of was interested in just its design and what problem it solved. It has this two-piece design where when you sit all the way back into the chair, it'll actually swivel, and it's supposed to simulate your body standing up. So that way your posture is automatically fixed and your hips aren't destroyed after long working sessions. That by itself already caught my eye, and I've been using this for the greater part of a year and actually has been helping my posture quite a bit. Office chairs for me are always super iffy since I sit quite a bit here at this desk when I work, whether it's coding, editing, or whatever, and I need a really good solid chair for when I'm not standing. And so far, I gotta say, this chair has done it for me. I don't have any affiliates with them, and I just recommend you go check this chair out. I think it's one of the products out of Shark Tank that actually work. Next piece of gear on this setup that a lot of people ask questions on is actually going to be my monitor. The model name is quite long, but it is an LG 49-inch monitor. The exact model name will be down in the description and somewhere on the screen. And I know you may be asking, are 49-inch monitors worth it? Do you like it? The short answer is yes and yes. I've had this since the end of 2019 and has been going strong since then. There are pros and cons, more pros for me personally than cons, but I do notice that my productivity levels are a lot higher than if I were working on normal 16:9 or 4K monitors that aren't ultra wide. I'm able to fit a lot more windows side by side, whether I'm working on a script for a video such as this one, doing research on the left side and writing the script on the right, or if I'm coding, I can have my web browser on the left side, my IDE in the middle, and then my terminal or my simulators if I'm working on a mobile application on the right hand side. So it's fairly easy to work with, and it's just super seamless instead of working with 2 or 3 monitors and trying to orient them the way that you want them to. Now, some cons that I find with this monitor is that having meetings with this isn't always the easiest, especially on Zoom or Google Meets. If I want to share my screen, it's a little difficult, and I do have to share tab by tab or window by window. I can't really share my whole screen unless someone else also happens to have a 49-inch ultra wide monitor, which is not a high chance. But I do not regret my purchase and will continue to use this 49-inch ultra wide until it goes down on me. I have been looking at the Odyssey Arc and plenty of other ultra wide monitors. So if you're out there, Sony, Samsung, LG, whoever, and you want me to take a look at your monitors, I'm your guy. Everything from this monitor is connected through USB. So I'm routing my keyboard, an SD card reader, and my light that I will go into later on in this video, all into the monitor, and then I'll feed into my MacBook M1 Max 16 inch through USB-C straight from the monitor. So I'm not using any docks. Everything is run through a single cable, and that's the way that I intend to keep it. I want everything to be super minimal as well as functional in this setup, and this monitor helps me do that. The mount holding up this monitor is the AVLT single arm desk mount. When I was looking at mounts on Amazon, it was a little difficult to find one that people were confident in holding up a beast like this. This mount was a little weird in its description, but it works perfectly fine for this monitor if you are curious. Online, it was only supposed to hold 13 to 43 inch monitors. This being 49, I looked through the reviews and a lot of people actually used it for their 49 inch ultrawides. Not the specific model, but similar ones. So I took the plunge and it works perfectly fine. I don't have to do any weird modifications to the mount to be able to hold the weight up of the monitor. It holds perfectly fine and I'm still able to adjust the height no matter where I want it to be. The things about this mount that I don't like are going to be the USBs at the front. I don't really use them, nor do I use the 3.5 audio jacks in the front either. So the cables that are routed through the back are just kind of zip tied still and staying in the back. Kind of clutters up the cables underneath the table, but I'll live with it for now since this mount wasn't that expensive. I have been asked a couple times about wobble when I'm typing or moving the mouse, and I gotta say there is a very little amount of wobble, but it's not crazy to where I want to change out this mount. I know there's some Ergotron mounts out there that you can buy, but they're super expensive and I want to keep this a little bit budget friendly, so this one was the way to go. I have no complaints whatsoever except for the USB mounts in the front that I just don't use. Now, I mentioned how the monitor feeds into my laptop, and what my laptop is sitting on is a Vivo single arm laptop mount. I used to have my laptop vertically just sitting on my desk using some sort of Jarvis mount that I found on Amazon, but it took up a lot of space surprisingly and felt cluttered to me when I'm working on the desk. So I wanted it to sit off onto the side as well as have a functional aspect where if I need to share my screen, then I can actually just go on my laptop screen and share it there. And it's a lot more flexible for other users or a lot of my other teammates that I work with when I need to share something in a meeting. And it just looks good. So it's not just an aesthetic purpose. It's also a functional purpose as well. So that is the laptop mount that I use. Next thing on the desk is going to be my keyboard of choice. Right now I'm running the Newfi Halo 75 with Rose Glacier switches. Newfi has been sending out a bunch of keyboards to me, and of all the keyboards that I've used and that they sent to me, the Halo 75 just feels and looks the best, especially in that white color. It has a ghost space bar that they boast and it quiets the space bar just nicely. And everything is lubed, including the stabilizers, so it sounds super thawky and I love typing on this. I do have some baby kangaroo switches that I want to switch out of this keyboard right now just to test and see, but this keyboard all in all has been an awesome workhorse for me, whether it's coding, writing, editing videos, anything like that. This has been my go-to so far on this desk. And if you're curious and interested about this keyboard, I do have a 10% off code that you can find down below. Just use code Justin when you check out at Newfi's website, and you can get 10% off of any purchase you find on their website. To the left and right of the keyboard are going to be my mouse and trackpad. I do use both and they both serve different purposes. So for the mouse right now, I'm using the Logitech MX Master 3S. And for the trackpad, I'm using the Apple Magic Trackpad 2. Logitech sent out the MX Master 3S to me a couple months ago, and I've been using it honestly ever since they sent it to me. I've been a big fan of the MX series and the mice, the way that it feels, the functionality from all the different buttons and the side scrolling is just an absolute godsend when it comes to productivity. This is not the Mac version of the MX Master 3S. There is a separate Mac version in case you are on Mac OS. This one is built for Windows, but connects just the same with Bluetooth, and I haven't had any issues aside from some very, very minor stuttering, but it just reconnects and then you're good. Now, when I'm editing videos or when I need to do some sort of gestures like swiping between desktops, I'll use the Apple Magic Trackpad 2, and it definitely does help there. When I'm in Final Cut Pro, just pinching to zoom and shortening a lot of the clips in the timeline with the trackpad is a lot easier than having to deal with the MX Master 3S. So that's why I have the trackpad off to the left-hand side. It just makes navigating through macOS a lot easier, as well as just making making my workflow a lot faster. The desk mat that all of these peripherals are sitting on are the Nomad desk mat. This recently launched from Nomad, and they sent this out also to me, and I've been using it since they've been giving it to me, trying to formulate an opinion slash review. And I gotta say, this is one of the more interesting desk mats that I've actually received. The top is completely waterproof, so no matter what you spill on it, it's not gonna damage the leather, so you don't have to worry about that. And underneath it is a felt material, but as well as an anti-slip pad that really does prevent the mouse pad from moving when you're doing any sort of intense work or you're swiping a lot. It actually doesn't move, which I found a lot of desk mats actually just do. And I actually refrain from using any desk pads that move while I'm working. So this one definitely passes that test. So far, there's only one size for it and it fits my desk just fine. But if you want to check it out, I definitely would recommend checking it out. It is a little pricey, but I think fairly worth it for the materials that they use and the functionality it gives. All right, so let's move to my audio setup now. And it's a little complicated, but not too complicated at the same time. The mic that I'm using is the Shure SM7B. That is mounted on top of the Elgato low profile mic arm. Both of these have both an aesthetic and functional use as well. As you could tell, the pattern that I have on this setup is I wanna have something that's aesthetically pleasing as well as serves a functional purpose. And for this audio setup, I needed something that was low profile. I have one of the Rode Boom mic arms and it just gets in the way a lot of the time. It sits on my streaming setup right now, which I will be doing a video on soon. The low profile definitely just gets out of the way. I can move it in and out and it still stays out of my way most of the time. It is definitely nice to have and less distracting, especially when I'm on meetings. From the Shure SM7B, that then feeds into my preamp, which is the DBX286S. This is where I have my compressor, my noise gates, messing with the highs and lows, and my gain as well. I don't use a cloud lifter with the Shure SM7B in this setup, since the preamp takes care of most of the gain that I need to get this to high enough levels. From the preamp, that'll then run into the Focusrite Scarlett Solo that I've had for quite some time. It's a super simple audio interface. You just plug the mic in through XLR. From there, you go out to the USB, and that USB then plugs into the back of the monitor, which then anytime I plug a device into the monitor through USB-C, my mic will always be ready to go on that device. And that is why I kind of use my monitor as a dock. But this mic setup all delivers really, really clean audio. I don't have to touch anything really. And again, like I said, if I'm switching between laptops from my personal to my work laptop, I don't have to touch any of the audio. Everything is good to go. So that way when I'm on Zoom meetings or if I need to do a voiceover for a video, every setting is already dialed in per my environment. Now into some of the accessories around the desk. To the right-hand side of the desk is going to be my storage unit that I recently purchased. This is the Beckent storage unit that I got from IKEA. A little expensive. This was around $300, but honestly serves the purpose that I need very well. It houses my NAS, my modem slash router that I wanted to clean out, as well as all of my photo slash video gear. I'm much more organized and I have more spots to fit every piece of camera equipment that I have, including lenses, camera bodies, caps, and lens caps, as well as SD cards. They're all accessible. I know where they are, and it displays my NAS and modem nicely, and I don't have to hear the NAS noise anymore since I used to have it on my desk. The webcam that I have on top of the monitor is the Anker PowerConf C300. Anker sent that out to me as well, and it's a pretty decent webcam, nothing too crazy. It has some AI tooling. It has really good quality, especially when the lighting is on point. Speaking of lighting, let's go over the lights around the setup as well. The key light that I use at this desk, especially for meetings, is the Elgato key light. I've got a ton of those. I have at least three total, one for this setup and two for the streaming setup. Works really, really well on the mobile control center app whenever I want to turn it on. And it has a lot of range in terms of the lighting and brightness, as well as temperature, depending on how I want the look to feel. But I just love Elgato products, and the key light is one of my best purchases that I've made. The webcam is sitting on a BenQ Screen Bar Plus. They also sent that out to me. As you can tell, a lot of this stuff has been sent out to me, but that actually has been really, really nice to have on my desk. Whenever I need to write anything on the desk or when at night and I need a little bit of light, I can turn that on and it illuminates my whole desktop. That way I can see it's not super dark, and I can turn the tone or the temperature of the light super cool or really warm, depending on how I want it to feel and how I want it to look. I've got a couple Govi lights as well around the desk. The one to the right hand side is the Govi floor lamp that provides some nice accent lighting to the right hand side of the desk, that which looks really good on videos like this or photos that I also take on Instagram. Right above the desk is the Govi Glides. The Govi Glides have been featured in a lot of my setups, especially the streaming setup, but I recently brought it here since I've moved my streaming setup out into the living room. This, I think, just adds a really nice accent piece as well to the very top of the setup and really helps the Instagram videos just pop. And then attached to the desk are some Govi LED lights that I just stripped from the backside and underneath the desk that provides some really good lighting. Again, just all for accents. Last but not least, since a lot of people have been asking this on social media, is what is the clock? The clock is a Google Nest Hub Max. I bought it off a whim. I really wanted a clock on my desk just to be able to tell the time, so that way I don't have to look up to the top right, because the ultra wide monitor is a little far away when it comes to the time. But if I just want a quick glance or want to use Google Assistant, then I will use the Google Nest Hub Max, which has been just sitting on my desk and looks really, really good as well on social media posts. So that right there wraps up my setup for 2023. I hope you all enjoyed this. As I mentioned before at the beginning of this video, every piece of gear that you heard me talk about on this video will be listed down below in the description. So if you want to check any of those out, please head down to the description below and you can check those out, and they are affiliate links. So it does help me directly to be able to provide more videos like this for you. I do plan on doing more tech reviews in the future. And I think the next setup video that you're gonna see from me is going to be my stream setup that is right across the room. And I know a lot of people have been interested in that, so I do plan on covering it fairly soon. Anyways, if you have any questions, please hit me up in the comment section below and I will answer them. But I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace.